Hilchas Maisa Korbanos Perek Shvi. So the Rambam started Maisa Korbanos giving us general halachas b'negiyah korbanos, halachas which are kail all korbanos. He told us all the different types of korbanos that there are, which behemoths that can be brought from, which type of behemoths could be used for which type of korbanos, then general dinim about zrikas adam, general dinim about many types of korbanos. Now the Rambam is getting involved in more b'protius. So in Perek Shishi he spoke about Maisa Ho'ila, and here in Perek Shvi the Rambam is going to talk about the dini of Chatos. Now in Chatos there's three types of Chatois. There's a Chatos HaNecheles, which is a Chatos HaBehema, which is Nasis Bachutz and goes on the Mizbeach HaChitzen, and that Chatos is Necheles. And then there's the Chatos, which could be either a Korban Yochid or a Korban Tzibur. Korban Yochid is when a person brings a Chatos for a Chayvei Krisus, and a Korban Tzibur of the Chatois, which are brought B'meyadim, or that's the Chatois HaTzibur VaYochid that we say in Izeo Mekeimon. And then there's the Chatois HaNisrofis, which we learned before there are five Chatois HaNisrofis. There's the two Chatois HaNisrofis, which are done B'Yom Kippur, which are a special Dinim of Azo, that's the Par and the Sur. And then there's the Chatois HaNisrofis, which is the Par Hel and Davar Shel Tzibur, and al derech zeh the par kein ha-moshiach, and there's the siri avidah zara. So that's another type of chatois. That's again the chatois which is nasis b'fnim, which are chatois and nisrofis. And then there's a chatos o'eif, which is a chatos o'eif, is also a chatos. That's something which is completely nechel, actually. The only thing that goes on the mizbech of the chatois, chatos o'eif is only the dam, like we learn b'protius. Perek Shvi. Mitzvah sasei lasis hachatois kimitzvosun ho'amurim b'teira. The ketzad ma'is hachatos hanechelos. So first he starts off with chatos hanechelos, that type of chatos which is nechelos. Sheichet. And then v'noisin adam k'meshe b'yarno, which we learned earlier, that's the shtei maton shein arba, the same like the oil and the osham, that you take the mizrok and you pour it on the two corners of the mizbeach diagonally. And then umafshita, then you do the hefshit of the chatos. Umafrisho imurim, you take away the imurim which have to go onto the mizbeach. Umelchom, and you salt the imurim. And vizerikum al gabi oishim is put on top of the ishim bizrika. You do not just place, but you're actually zerikin al gabi oishim. And vimrot, like we learned in the oila, vimrot salitnus imurim bekelik shemilichin lizbeach nesim. When you actually bring the imurim to the mizbeach, you have that choice to put the fats, the things that you're putting, the imurim, which is the chele, which is b'chasis hakerev, and the yiseres hakoved, and the kloyes. If you want to put it into a keli, when you bring it to the mizbeach, that's an option nason. Ushar psor, and the rest of the meat of the behema, of the chatos, is nechel lezichrei kohuna, only embazor. So the chatos, you shecht it, and then you zeig the dam, and then you take out, you make the hefshit, you take out the imurim, you put it on top of the mizbeach, and then the rest of the basar is eaten only the zecher kun. That's chatois hanecholos. Halacha beis v'ketzed ma'isa chatois hanisrofis. Also the same seder, the chatchila is the same seder as sheichet. Then the zeirik domum k'meshe b'yarnu, which we learned what's the din of chatois and nisrofis, and in that gufa there were two types. There was the chatois and nisrofis of Yom Kippur, which you go into the Kedesh HaKadoshim, and there's the eight hazois, and then there's the hazoh on also besides the corners of the Mizbeach Hazov. It's also on the gag of the Mizbeach Hazov. Mashenk and the other chatois and nisrofis are only seven hazois on the kaperis and dalet hazois on the Mizbeach Hazov. That's what we learned earlier. V'achar kach koyrom, so you make the shkita and then you make the zrika, and then you koyreya the stomach of the behema, the umetzu heimurim, and you take out the emurim, those things that are going to go onto the mizbeach, which are the same like by the chatois apnimius, which is chatois anecholos. The only difference between the chatois anecholos and the chatois anestrophis is benigea the basar. Masha'inkin, as far as the emurim are concerned, they're the same emurim. Umeitzu heimurim v'neisten bekeli umeilchon v'zeir kan al gabi oishim umeitzu she'erison chutz la'ir umenat k'neisum shom kinitchi oile. Over there, chutz la'ir, when you're going to burn it, over there you cut it up like the nitchi oile. So, but again, the chatois hanecholes, There's no din of how you cut it up. You're going to eat the basar, so you cut it up as how you want to cut it up. Masha'inkin, since over here you're going to burn it, so burning, even though you're burning it b'chutz, you're not burning it on the mizbeach, but you're supposed to cut it up in the same way. We learned the whole seder of how you cut up the different parts of the oila. So in the same way, that's how you cut up the katois hanisrafis. You cut it up outside with the place where you're going to burn it, which is outside Yerushalayim. Umnat chneisim sham chnitche oila be'oiram. And over here also, there's a chiddush that you don't take off the oir. Because by chatois hanacholus, you take off the oir. By the oila also, which goes on top of the mizbeach, you take off the skin. You skin the animal. Masha'inkim, when we're talking about chatois hanisrafes, they are burned with the oir. And you burn it bebeis adeshen. Now halacha gimel shleisha mekemus l'sreifa. Bechlal, there were three places where you burned. There's besides the mizbeach, obviously. We're talking about shleisha mekemus where things were burnt. Echad b'techo azara. There was a place in the azara to burn kachim. Ubei serifim psuli hamukdashim. Over there you burn things that became possible. Pashus means something that became possible. Kodesh HaKadoshim. And also the Imurim of Kachim Kalim, Shinifsalu. The Imurim of Kachim Kalim, which also belong in the Azara, because they would have been, they're brought onto the Mizbeach, the Imurim. So the Imurim of Kachim Kalim, Shinifsalu, are also burnt in the Azara. And also Uparim Usirim, Shel Chatois and Israfis, Im Irebem Sul. If there was a psul that occurred in these parim anisrafim, bein lifnei zika, bein lachar zika. If the psul happened in the azara, see, even though these are parim anisrafim, which really the basar should be going out of the azara, it should be on its way out of the azara, but the bale didn't go out of the azara, it's kachim kadoshim. So the din is that parim anisrafim, mesirim anisrafim, if there was a psul, even after zrika, so l'chura that's ready to go out of the azara, nevertheless, it's burned in the Azara. Again, shenitmu, that's one option. Eshiyotzu chutz la'azara, actually, yagia zmanim lotzes. Or if they went out of the Azara, kedem sheyagia zmanim lotzes, so, almost before Zrika, so also you take it back and you burn it in the Azara. Oy shalon habasar, or if the basar was lon, eshalon uhaimunim shalom, or the imurim were lonu. So any psul that happened to kachi kadoshim, that happened either, in other words, it happened in the Azara, or it happened in a way that it shouldn't have been outside the Azara. In other words, if it already reached outside the Azara, and it was supposed to be outside the Azara, and then it became a psul, it became tamei, that's the next halach. That over there, you're going to burn it outside on the harabais. Masha'inkin, if they were nifsal in the Azara, or they were even though they were supposed to already go out of the Azara, or they went out of the Azara, but they weren't really supposed to be out of the Azara. They were supposed to be in the Azara. So then they're burned in the Azara. Masha'inkel Marshal Kachim Kalim, which Kachim Kalim, if they were Nifsal, in other words, before they went out of the Azara, but they were supposed to be going out of the Azara. For example, it was the Basar of Kachim Kalim, which are Nechol and Gantz Yerushalayim, and it was already Lachar Zrika, so they really belong outside the Azara. And nevertheless, it became Nifsal in the Azara. So you don't burn Kachim Kalim in the Azara. You'll burn Kachim Kalim outside the Azara. So that was Pekitzer. So we're learning about the places, the things that are burnt in the Azara. Let's go over the Halacha, Nachamo. The things that are burnt in the Azara, you burn Psuli HaMukdashim, and the Imurim of Kachim Kalim Shenifsal. He didn't speak about the Basar of Kachim Kalim. He spoke about the Imurim of Kachim Kalim Shenifsal, or Uparim Usirim HaChayit HaTois and Nisrafis. If the psul happened in the Mikdash, bein lifni zrika, bein lachar zrika, or there could be another situation, and that happened in the Azara, a sheyotzu chutz la'azara, actually yigia zman amlotzes. So again, that would also go into the category of something which is nisraf in the Azara. Halacha dalet, amokim hasheni, which was Bahar Abayis, ushmei bira, ubei serfun chatois hanisrafis, if the psul happened after they went out of the Azara, and they went out of the Azara kalocha, not like we had before in Halacha Gimel, yotzu chutz la'azara, actually yigia zman amlotzes. We're talking about they went out of the Azara kalocha, the dam was was Nizrak, and now they're supposed to burn the Basar, and they started going out of the Azara, but the Vayla, after it went out of the Azara, it became Nifsal. So then, that's burned in the Harabayas. And now, V'hamokim HaShlishi was Chutz Yerushalayim, V'hu HaNikra Beis HaDeshem, V'shom Serfim Chatois HaNisrofis, Bizman Shein Nisrofis Kimitzvosim. So it was the third place, that was the place, that was the proper place of burning the Chatois HaNisrofis, and the Rambam says, that was Chutz Yerushalayim, and that was called Mekei Madashim. There's Nochem also, there was one place in the Azara, which was for Kotchi Kodoshim, which were Nifsal in the Azara, and also the Imurim of Kotchim Kalim, which were Nifsal in the Azara, or of Chatois HaNisrofes, which went out of the Azara when they shouldn't have gone out of the Azara, when they went out of the Azara and they shouldn't have gone out of the Azara. Then you have a place on the Harabayas, that's for Chatois HaNisrofes, which went out of the Azara and they should have gone out of the Azara. But Lepel, then they were Nifsal. And then you have another place, which is Chutz L'Yushalayim, and over there you burn Chatois HaNisrofes, which are supposed to be burnt. Halacha Hey. Usreifas Kol HaNisrofim is Ksheira Bezor Ubalayla. So those things that are being burned, you're burning, you know, we're talking about Psulei HaMukdashim, also, not only Psulei HaMukdashim, but also when you're burning Chatois HaNisrofes, which is not Psulei HaMukdashim, but it's a Chi of Sreifa, nevertheless it can be done Bazor Ubalayla. V'Kol HaNisrofim Chutz La'Azora, There's another thing, Kolo Eitzim Ksheirim L'Sreifa. Rav B'Negeya, the Sreifa, that's on top of the Mizbeah, there was special Dinam B'Negeya, the Eitzim. Masha'ikin, those that are in the Sreif, M'chutz La'Azara, is Kolo Eitzim Ksheirim L'Sreifasan, Afilu B'Kash U'B'Gaveva, which is straw and stubble, Shnamar Al Eitzim Bo'esh. So we learn out Eish Mikol Makom, as long as it's fire. V'lom Enemar Eitzim, but it does says Al Eitzim Bo'esh. L'Hoitzi is Asid V'Saremetz. You shouldn't use lime and you shouldn't use ashes. In other words, it should be something which is clearly that is being burned from the fire. It should be clear that it's the fire. Masha'enkin, as long as it's fire, it makes no difference what kind of wood is being used. Now, the Lashon HaRambam is that anything that is burned outside the Azara, which means in the Azara, even though in the Azara also there was a burning of Kotchim HaNifsolim, those that are Kotchim Kadoshim or Imuri Kotchim Kalim. So the Radva says you don't bring into the Azara things that are not Eitzim. It's like not Derecher, it's not inside the Hilchus Reifa. Inside Hilchus Reifa there's no special din of Eitzim. But on the other end, in the Azara, you don't bring Eitzim, you don't bring those Eitzim which aren't Kosher L'Mizbeach. So therefore, for that Sreifa, we start done with regular Eitzim. Masha'enkin, those in the Sreif outside the Azara, can be done with any Eitzim, and it can be even done the Kasher B'Gavva, as long as you don't use Sid and remnants, lime and ashes. Halacha Vov. Now, so we learned about Achatas HaNecheles, and we learned about Chatois HaNisrof. Now, Chatas HaEiv, Ketzotois HaNasis, is Moilikoisa Bekern Droimis Marovis. We learned earlier, B'Negeh, the Oila HaEiv was Bekern Droimis Mizrochis, and it was also, you were Oila Bakevish, and it was done on the Seiviv. That's where you made the Malika, on the Oila Sa'if was Bekern Droimis Mizrochis. Now over here, the Chata Sa'if is not done Lamaila, it's done Lamata. That's the difference. It's easy to remember, an Oila is Lamaila, Masha'ik and Achatas is Lamata. And it's done not Bekern Droimis Mizrochis, but it's rather Bekern Droimis Marovis. Kimesha Biyarnu. And the Yered Bit Siporne, and what do? You make the Malika, you Yered Siporne, Achi Achta Chasimonim. Over here, but again, the oil, he said it should be achter kolasimon, and over there, you also there was a din you're supposed to be mavdal. The Rambam holds you have to be mavdal but again, on oil. The question is if it's you're allowed to be mavdal or you have to be mavdal. The Rambam said you have. There's a mitzvah to be mavdal. The mitzvah is to be mavdal, and the yeded mitzvah. Not only it's a mitzvah. That was the yikuvah. You have to be mavdal the oil, and over here the Rambam was saying the yeded mitziporni achi achter chasimon oirev echad mem. Ve'enei mavdil ha'resh min ha'guf. When you get the chatos is not, you're not mavdil the resh min ha'guf. Ve'em hivdil posel v'leka. Shenemar umolek es resh min mul orpe v'le yavdil. So mainly you make the malika and you sever either reiv of one simon or both simonim, but you're not mavdil, you don't decapitate the head of the oif. Umaza midoma al kira mizbeach lematem emtzoi. So you go and you're mazif, you sprinkle from the dam of this oif on the kira mizbeach lematim emtsoy. So in other words, the oil over there that dogish was that you kvetch it. You take the dam and you kvetch it to the mizbeach, and there has to be lemailem emtsoy. Over here he's saying umazo midom. Over there wasn't umazo. Over there you took it and you put it, you pushed it onto the mizbeach. Your mazim midom al kira mizbeach lematim emtsoy. Then he says, "V'shiri adam, the leftover dam is mismatzim ala yiseit." Now, mismatzim bashes means it's kvetched out. It's not so clear. Shenamar, "V'hanisher badam yimotze al yiseit amizbech." Miklal, "Shehanesina al kir, shehashiyorin shalei mismatzim ala yiseit." V'zeo kir atachten. So, in other words, what's the raya that the oif has to be on the chelik atachten? Because it says, "V'hanisher badam yimotze al yiseit amizbech." Now the question is, does yimotzi mean that you're supposed to kvetch it out? Mitzui means after you sprinkle from the dam onto the kir, you go ahead and you push the oif onto the kir, and that's how you kvetch out al yiseid hamizbeach. Or it means that when you sprinkle the dam, so the dam that's being sprinkled and is going onto the mizbeach, so it drips down, and it drips down onto the yiseid. So if you go ahead and sprinkle it lemaila from the emtza, so the lav dafka will never reach the yisayit. In other words, it's going to stop by the seviv, maybe. It'll never really reach the yisayit. Masha'ikin, if you sprinkle it onto the bottom, so then yimotzei. So the pashas advarim is that the lashon yimotzei means that from the dam that you were maza on the kiram mizbeach, it's going to be yimotzei. It's going to come down onto the yisayit. So that teaches us that the hazor has to be on the chelik atach, and that's l'chura de pshat. The Rambam doesn't say clearly, because the Rambam, next halacha zayin, the Rambam says, umitzi dam chatus eif makif. So bepashas means there has to be, besides the hazor, there has to also be mitzi. Not so clear. In the whole hemshech advarim, and again, this din of hazor and mitzi, the Lech Mishnah asks, and other achrim, they ask a lot of kashas, but again, how it stems with the Gemaras. If the mitzvah, where the mitzvah has to be, and the dinim of mitzvah. Just saying, it's not so clear to me, the Seder HaPshat. Just we'll read it again. The Rambam says, Umazim idom al kiram mizbech lemato. Then the Lashon HaRambam is, Shiri adom mismatzim ala yaseit. Now, does that the taish mean that he makes mitzvah? Or does it mean, that's chura, Shiri adom mismatzim ala yaseit. He makes mitzvah ala yaseit. Shinama, now the Rambam is bringing, Manishar badom yimotze ala yaseit amizbech. Miklal shanesina al kir shashiyorim shalei mismatzim al yaseit. So over here we're talking about that shiori adam is mismatzim al yaseit. So the chur, it sounds like that from the dam that you were maza, so it drips down onto the yaseit. That's what he's saying. Vanisher badam yimotz al yaseit amizbech miklal shanesina al kir shashiyorim shalei mismatzim al yaseit. So how is it mismatzim from the azlo that the nesina al the kir is mismatzim ala yaseid, v'zeo kira tachten. Al kol ponim, and then the Rambam, so l'chure, if you read it like that, shiri adam, what's the pshat shiri adam? Shiri adam is l'chure, sounds like another dam. In other words, besides the hazor, there's also the dam, which is left in the oif, has to be mismatzim ala yaseid. So could be, some people learn, you learn two things from yimotzi, say that there's a din mitzui, that there's a chiv of, you have to be matzah, and also that the shiri adam is mismatzim. Knows that the dam itself, which you are maza, is also mismatzah. So knows it gets onto the yaseid two ways. First of all, there's mitzui, and then there's also that the dam, which you are maza, is also mismatzah al yaseid. It's sort of beer. But that's what the Rambam writes. Again, maza midom al kiram mizbech lamatim etzboi, that's clear. And then the Rambam continues, v'shiri adam mismatzah al yaseid. So we're thinking, what is the word mismatzah? Does it mean that you have to make mitzui? Is that the tight? Shenema v'anishar b'adam yimotz al yaseid amizbeach. If that's what it means, so l'chura the words miklal shanesin al kir shashiyor shleim mismatzim al yaseid v'zeo kir atachten is not so understood. Al kolpon. Then halacha zayin umitzui dam achatu seif ma'akev. You have to have mitzui adam. Ve'ein l'mizbeach bo el adama. The only thing that the mizbeach has from the chatu seif is the dam. Bahashar and everything else about the oif is nechal zikri kohuna, kipsar chatas abeim. So by chatas oif, the only thing that you do on the mizbeach is only the spring, this blood, the hazor and the mitzui. Halacha ches keitzad oiches chatusayif b'shas malika. How do you hold the chatusayif b'shas malika? How do you hold the chatusayif b'shas malika? Now the question is there a din dafken chatusayif? The Rambam L'chura, we learned about an oilusayif from Perek Vav, and here B'tamol we're learning about a chatusayif, and over here. So there's an argument in Achreinim. The Radvaz says that Hu Adin Oyla Soif, and not everyone agrees to the Radvaz. But that's what the Rambam writes: Ketzad Oichet Chato Soif B'Shas Malika, Oiches Shtei Ragle B'Shtei Esbeisof. So the 2 feet of the Oif is Ben Shtei Esbeisof. So it's brought down. So it means B'Shtei Esbeisof means between the Kmitza and between the Zeres and the Kmitza. The Zeres is the pinky. The Kmitza, I suppose, I think we call the ring finger. I think so. But I'll call upon him the fourth finger, the finger next to the pinky, I'll call upon him. So between the pinky and the fourth finger, that's where you keep the raglai. And then, that's between the fourth and third finger, between the amma and the koimitz. So that's where you have the 2 wings, are between those 2 fingers. And then you bring the tzavar, you schlep it in between the etzba and the amma. So the 4 fingers are there's the zeres, and then there's the kaimitz, and then there's the amma, and then there's the etzba. So between the zeres and the kaimitz, that's where you hold the legs. Between the amma, between the kaimitz and the amma, that's where you hold the wings. And between the amma and the etzba, that's where you hold the head. That's where you schlep out the head. Miteach tzavara reichem shteis beis of a melek. V'zu, and this aveda of doing the malika is mi avedis koshi shebemikdash. V'mshin of achas become a kusher. It was this way of holding the bird while you're doing the malika is not liyikuva. That's the way the seder was. That's the seder of doing malika. But lepeil is not liyikuva. Now, v'chol mokim min ha-mizbeach koshel mikosa. Even though he said before that lepel, the malika should be done in keren mizrochis dremis, maravis dremis rather, the maravis dremis, but lepel, kol mokim min ha-mizbeach koshel mikosa. U'bilvad, shiyaze domo lemata me'emtza mizbeach. What's likuvi is that the hazoyas hadam has to be lemata me'emtza mizbeach. And then he says, v'him hiza b'chol mokim. Now, this is also against the issue. Then he's a b'chol mokim k'shera. If the hazor was in any place, it was the pashta mashmoish means even lemaila mi'amtza mizbeach is k'shera. Aba v'hu she'itnu lemata ma'at midam ha'nefesh. That a little bit of the dam ha'nefesh should come lemata. So that also, these words, then he's a b'chol mokim k'shera. So in Gemara, the pashtas is going on the mitzvah, not on the hazor. The hazor has to be on the chelek ha'tachton. If it would be v'hi's a b'chol mokim lav dafke v'keren, Dremus Marovis, it would be easier to understand. Pashas Lashna Rambam, it sounds like he's a b'chol mokim, even l'mayla memtzo. That's the Lashna Rambam. So let's read the halacha test again. B'chol mokim in a mizbeach is kosher l'mlikos. You could make the malika any place in the mizbeach. Abir bulvad, so first the Rambam says, she'yazah doma l'matam emtza mizbeach. You have to be mazah, in other words, regardless of where you make the malika, the hazor has to be l'matam emtza mizbeach. And then the Rambam says, v'm he's a b'chol mokim, is kshera, abavahu sheit lamata ma'at midam ha'nefesh. In other words, the fact that you were maza partially lamaila didn't invalidate the carbon. It didn't become uis carbon. As long as part of the dam is niza lamata me'amtza. It doesn't have a din of shirayim, for example. Sometimes you have a din that something becomes shirayim, so it's possible. In other words, it doesn't become shirayim. He's a b'chol makom, it's still kshera, but as long as but you were yetzad azor. Dazo, you have to be yetsa. Part of the dam has to come lamata me'amtza mizbeach. That's l'chur what it said. Halacha yud shleisha dvarim hoisekeren dremis maravis mishameshes lamaila ushleisha lamata. The 3 things happened. This keren dremis maravis was like a very busy corner, so to speak. There were 3 things happening lamaila in this keren dremis maravis, and al deres there 3 things happening lamata. What was lamata? So first of all, Chatusayif, the normal seder of the Malika of Chatusayif, he said before, was in Keren, Dremis, Maravis, even though it's not Likuvah, but that was the normal seder. And also, V'Hagoshes HaMenachas, there's a din that all the Menachas that are brought, The Kohen has to take the mincha and bring it and be magish it to the Mizbech. He has to touch the Mizbech with the mincha. Now that din is Keren Dremis Marovis. Ushiori Adam, and there's another din, that Shiori Adam, Shal Oilis, V'chatois HaNecholis, and V'ashomis Ushlom, Shishef Kumala. In that corner, that was where the Shvichas Adam of all the Karbonis were, except for the Chatois HaNesrofis. Except for the Chatois HaNesrofis, all the Karbonis were always poured on that corner. And that corner, that corner was the entire Dharm wall didn't really have, Dharm side didn't have a Yisoid. The Yisoid was only like an Amma into that corner. And those the Meirev wall of the Mizbech had a Yisoid. And the Dharm wall, you only had a Yisoid for one Amma. And there were certain things that, so when you say that the Shiori Adam our nishpach al yisoy droimi of the mizbeach hachitzen. So when you say al yisoy droimi, the yisoy droimi means in that corner, which was the dreimus marovis, because there was no yisoy droimi. There was only the yisoy droimi was that amma in the place of the dreimus marovis. And over there were the two holes. One was like closer to the dorm, one was closer to the mairav, depending on what kind of carbon it was. But lapel, everything was poured into that corner. The all the dam, when you ushiori adam or yishevich al yisei dremi, the yisei dremi means in the corner of the dremus marovis. That's what he's saying. So ushiori adam shel eiles v'chatois hanecholes v'ashamis ushlamim of all the karbonis except for the chatois hanesrofis, everything was nishpach over there in that corner. Now that was the three things that was happening in the corner lamata. Now, Bashleishis Shalmaila, what was happening with Maila? So there was the Nisach HaMayim, Shemanaskim Bechag, which was also in that corner, Lamaila and Keren, Dremis Marovis, and also the Nisach HaYayin, Shemanaskim, every day there was Nisach HaYayin that was done in the Keren, Dremis Marovis, and also the Oilas HaOif, Bizman Shehi Rabba. Now, Bizman Shirabu, when there was a lot of Oilus Oif happening, so Mamela, you couldn't really get. Really, Lachatchila, the Oilus Oif you do in the Ken Dremis Mizrochis. So you're all of Akevish, Ufonel Asevev, and over there you go to the Ken Dremis Mizrochis. And that's where you do the Oilo. Mashainkin, the Oilus Oif, Bizman Shirabu, the main Ken Dremis Mizrochis, Bechila Eso. So there's a lot happening over there, so Mamela, you can't really go ahead. There's no room there. So then, Nifnin leKeren Dremis Marovis. So that's when you turn to the Keren Dremis Marovis, and you do it there. So basically, you have to do it on a corner. You should do it on a corner. You have to know what's this din of doing it on a corner. But the Eila Soe, if you do either on the Keren Dremis Mizrachis, and if there's no room on the Keren Dremis Mizrachis, so you go ahead and do it in the Keren Dremis Marovis. Now, Kol Eilam LeMizbech, when a person goes up to the Mizbech in the Kevish, so first of all, Eilim Derech Yimin, you go up on the right side of the Kevish. When you're walking up on the right side of the Kevish. Umakifin V'yerdin Derech Smel, then you go around, when you go around, so the first thing you make a right, it's called Pinush HaTepein, HaPein HaLiyimin, so you make a right, and then you go around, and then you go Derech Smel, which means on the other side of the Kevish. You know, when you're going down, really, that's your right side. But it would be Derech Smel, if you're looking at the Kevish, So when you go up, you're going from the right. And when you're coming down, you're coming from the left of the person that's looking at the kevish from the outside, from on the bottom. So Nachamal, Kol Eilum Mizbech, Eilum Derech Yimin, you go on the right side of the kevish, going up. And then Omakif, and then you go around from right, you go around, so it's like counterclockwise. And then the Yerdin Derech Smil, you go down Derech Smil, what looked like Derech Smil when you were going up. Chutz Mino Eilu Le'echad Bishleish Dvarim Eilu. These three things that we just said that are in Lamaila in the Keren Dremis Marovis, Shalamaila Bekeren Zu, Shein Oilim Venifna Lasmeil Lekeren, they turn left. They don't turn right because they're turning left. Ve'esim Alachton, and they do whatever they have to do over there on the left. And Ve'chazim Le'okkev, and then they go back from where they came from. Umipnima Nifna Lasmeil, why do they go left rather than most people they go right? Because she'im nifna, because normally you're supposed to go right. She'im nifna yimin, if you're going to go right, umakifin al kol hamizbech at sheyagiu lekeren dremis marovis, so you're going up with the yayin or with the mayim or with the oif that you're going to add and do this on the left. Shema yisashen amayim v'hayayim. Maybe the wine or the water will become full of smoke because you're going around the mizbeach. A shema yom usayv b'ashana mizbeach. There's a concern that the oif is going to die b'ashana mizbeach. So memela, so you don't want to go ahead and go around the mizbeach. You go to the right, you go around to the mizbeach until you get to that corner because you're afraid what's going to happen to either the water or to the wine or to the oif by the time you get there. Lefichach, hamenasech mayim ayayim. L'chura means to say if there's a person that's making the nisach hamayim ayayin and he wants to be makav hamizbech, he doesn't want to go to the smell. So k'shu makav hamizbech, if lepel he's being makav hamizbech, is le'yeh b'yodi klum. So what does he do? Umaskel, umakav mikad gremis mizrachis, mizrachis tzvenis, tzvenis marovis marovis gremis. So he goes taka around, he goes onto the mizbech and he walks around, abav le'yeh b'yodi klum, he shouldn't be holding anything. If he is being makif, ukshimagil marav is dreimus, and when he reaches the marav is dreimus, is someone standing over there on the kevish, or on the front of the mizbech, and noisn hamayim ayayin biyadi menasach. Then he gives him the yayin or the mayim, and he's menasach. Vimlehikiv, but if he doesn't, is not makif. So what does he do? Oyla upein al smeina veisim alachti v'yeid. So basically, there's an option. There's an option you can have insist that you want to be makif. So then someone else will give you the mayim or the yayin, or you have the other option of not being makif, and then going to your, then you'll go to your left, you won't go to your right. Now, the ma'ase is just saying that when a person goes, just the point of, that when a person goes and does the oyla, and he does it b'kadem dremis mizrachis, he goes on the seviv. He doesn't go onto the mizbeach, he goes onto the seviv, and he does it on the seviv. Now, the Rambam is saying in the case when there's no room over there, there's too much going on, and therefore you're going to do it rather than in Keren Dremis Mizrachis, you're going to be doing it in Keren Dremis Maravis. So how are you going to get? So you're not going to be going on the Seva of the Keren Dremis Maravis, it seems to be. Over there, you're going to have to go on to the Mizbech of the Keren Dremis Maravis, not on the Seva. Because if you're going on the Seva, so this concern of the Ashana Mizbech, first of all, the Chur is not there. And secondly, if there's no room to get to the Keren Dremis Mizrachis, how are you going to get around and around? So meanwhile, we're talking about a person that there's no room to get to the Keren Dremis Mizrachis. Things are too busy over there. So he goes up all the way to the Mizbeach, and he walks around the Mizbeach, and he's doing it the Keren Dremis Maravis of the Mizbeach. L'chura, that's the pshat. And then, so that's the case. So then there's a concern of the Ashana Mizbeach. If he wouldn't be doing it on the Mizbeach, l'chura, there wouldn't be a concern of the Ashana Mizbeach. And certainly, the Nisach HaMayim is done on top of the Mizbech. And as when a person goes to do the Nisach HaMayim or Hayayin, he goes on top of the Mizbech. He doesn't go on the Seviv. So the Pashas, we're putting him into the same category. So he's also, so I'm saying, on the Keren, Dremis Mizrachis, over there he does it on the Seviv. Masha'enkin, the Keren, Dremis Maravis, over there he's doing it on top of the Mizbech.